drops. Where to begin? I met him 2 years ago at summer leadership camp. You could say I was a swing dancing practice dummy. Over time, we've become really close friends, and I would even consider him as part of my family. For those of you that don't know, Hunter and I, we know how to live it up. Between hour-long FaceTime calls, adventures in Walmart, and trips to Tahoe, we've done it all. A few things that Hunter may not know is that over the 2 years we have been friends, he's become a mentor to me. Hunter has taught me some valuable lessons, as well as some pretty cool swing dance moves. He taught me how to be myself, even when it might be embarrassing, and I'm sure he's got plenty of stories to prove that. He's shown me the qualities that make a great leader and how to use those qualities to build up others. He showed me how to stand up for what you believe in, even when it might not be the most popular opinion. And these are just a few of the countless things I've been able to learn from him. Like I said earlier, I consider Hunter as part of my family. A little background information for all of you is that I'm an only child. I've never had the experience of having a sibling, but Hunter has filled the big brother role in my life, and I couldn't ask for anybody better to call my brother from another mother. Hunter Dross, I may have only known you for 2 years, but you've made a lasting impact on my life. I love you so much, and I can't wait to see what the future has in store for you. You're almost out of the woods. You got this. Thank you.
Well, I thought I was going to try to leave all the crying to Sydney over here, but I started tearing up already, so hopefully this goes well. As many as you know, Hunter has attended more than his fair share of school dances these last 4 years. And actually, he went to more of the dances at my school than I did, which many may think is kind of weird, but I always admired him for making time to let his hair down and have good, clean, fun with people. In addition to being a social butterfly, Hunter is also the epitome of ambition. From driving hundreds of miles in one day for a Taylor Swift concert, to going 2 days without sleep to ensure yet another leadership event goes smoothly. He runs a Mountain Dew, thrives without sleep, and always executes a task with an impressive amount of refinement. I can never understand how he can balance so many things on his plate without being a complete mess, but he did, does, and will always kick ass at anything he puts his mind to. I have never been more proud to call someone my friend and cannot wait to see what he will accomplish down the road, because I guarantee we have not seen the last of Hunter Dross.
I'm Sydney, I'm his little sister, and from the looks of Caitlin, there's not a good chance I'm going to get through this speech without crying, so bear with me. But I bet Hunter is standing there inside, wondering and sweating what I'm going to say about him in this next minute and a half. But I mean, it can't be worse than when I convinced our entire school, teachers, principals, students, and some parents that he was adopted. Yes, I know, I'm very caring. But when he told me I was going to introduce him, I was so excited, but I was at a dilemma. I didn't know exactly what to say or that would do him justice, but anyone who's had the privilege of meeting him will definitely understand where I'm coming from. Hunter is by far the most dedicated and high energy person I've ever met. I'm still questioning if he knows what sleep is, and if someone can tell him, that'd be great. He's always up for a new challenge, whether that be a school project or raising a market lamb to show with me. He always jumped right in, and although he might not be the best, you know for a fact it wasn't because of his lack of effort. Hunter also loves adventure, whether it be going to Paris for his 16th birthday or buying plane tickets to Washington, D.C. impulsively. But I truly think that this year has been the best adventure of all because of you guys. Although Hunter and I do have our sibling rivalries, again, sorry I convinced everyone you were adopted. We still always have each other's backs, and for that I am eternally grateful. Hunter, you will go far in whatever dreams you choose to pursue, and I am so proud to be able to call you my big brother. Nevada FFA, I am pleased to introduce to you your 2018-2019 State Secretary, Hunter Dross.
putting first things first. Cause when our glass runs out of sand, you can't rip it over and start again. Take every breath God gives you for what it's worth.
Just a little bit better looking than I am now, sneaking out the back door and away from my parents' watchful eyes. My curiosity led me to go outside and climb the corral to end up sitting on the horse we had there. Now, before I get your hopes up, this is where my story ends. I'm sure you're all expecting some dramatic accident or injury to occur. But unlike my current state of life, I didn't injure myself here for some reason. That's because my parents had been there to get me off before I could do any damage. I didn't ask for help in a situation where I could have really used it. No matter how different each and every one of us in this room are, we can all relate to needing help and giving it to others. It is inevitable that everyone in this room is going to find themselves in a situation where they don't have a solution to the issue they are facing. A few years ago, I found myself in a situation where I needed help. Getting ready to crawl into a deep, dark tunnel at a leadership camp in Washington. My mind started going a million miles an hour as we started crawling deeper and deeper into the tunnel. My mind quickly started racing. I was wondering how I was going to get past the people in front of me and avoid certain death. What do I do if this tunnel collapses in on me? What am I going to do? This was until I heard a voice from behind me. The voice was a shy girl named Miranda having a panic attack. My brain quickly realized that there was somebody in need who needed help. Now, I had no idea what I could do to help, but I knew I couldn't just sit there. I had to do something. Not knowing what I was doing, we started talking. We started talking about school, about her younger brother, and even about her single mother, who works two full-time jobs just to put food on their table. In that moment, I went from feeling trapped to feeling like I was exactly where I needed to be. She showed me that in every struggle we face, there is an opportunity. We all have an incredible opportunity every day that we get out of bed. We can support and love one another. But more than that, we can make an impact on other people's lives. We do this for the help we give and the help we receive. We do this because we don't know what will happen next. Imagine for a moment how much better our world would be if we simply helped one another. My conversation with Miranda showed me that I don't have to know exactly what I'm doing to make an impact. She showed me that everyone is uniquely qualified to help those in need, that I could help. Now, think about a time where you probably should have asked for help in a situation, and like many of us, you didn't. What was that situation? Let's shout that out right now. What was that situation?
Wow.
Exactly. Some of us are shy sharing what we need help with. And it's difficult for us to ask for help. Now shift gears and think about a time where you helped somebody else. How did you feel afterwards? Now, if you're anything like me, you felt pretty good. You felt valued and needed. You felt like you had a purpose, that you could make an impact on somebody's life. So why is it then that when we need help, we struggle to give this same opportunity to others? Why is it that in our lives we shy away from asking for help? Why don't we let others feel good? Now, go ahead and do me a favor and stand up for just a moment. Let's take out one of our hands and reach out to a person next to us. When we do this, we are reaching out a helping hand. While it may be cliche, there is nothing more important than
helping hand.
It is important though, however, when we reach out and have help, that we accept that same help. Have a seat for me. Thank you. It's important that when we are in a situation where we are being offered help, that we accept that help. That we give opportunity to others to make them feel good. Now, even as a toddler, I struggled to ask for help. I struggled to know what was best for me. I didn't want to give the opportunity to others. This year, I thought I would be the one helping everybody in this room, but in reality, it was the other way around. You helped me all more than you could ever imagine. You made this year unbelievable. You showed me how diverse we are. You supported me along the way, and you showed me the power in being unique. I could never put a price on the memories I've made this year traveling around this fantastic state. Nevada State, today is the day we can change lives. Today is the day we can make an impact. Think about how much better our world and our country would be if we simply helped one another. We must be courageous in our lives to accept help and to give it to others when it is most needed. I can't thank everybody in this room enough for lending me a giant helping hand this year.
I can speak for the whole team when we say that you are that brother who keeps us all on track. Not for the team, but for our family. I mean it from the bottom of my heart when I say you have been like a brother to me this year and to all of us here. I don't know where our team would be without you always having your work done and setting an example for the rest of us. Hunter, thank you for being part of our family. I'm pleased to present you with your retiring jacket.
Nevada FFA, for the last time, for 2018-2019, Nevada FFA State Secretary, Hunter Tron!